Good morning, ayo, what's good, it's your boy Wolfie, and guys, before I begin the vlog, I'm feeling sad. Sylvia just left New York this morning, she's gone, the dogs are at my mom's house, they're gone, and the boys are in Cancun, so they're not even here, I'm all alone.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely.
Okay, I'm joking. Freedom! Let's go! Got the house to ourselves. It's party time. Party tonight. Let's get it. Everyone reach. Let's get it. It's party time. Sylvia's gone. Woohoo! Anyways, I hope you guys on that light-spirited mood are having a great day. Smash the like button right now because Wolf Fam is the like gods of YouTube. And YouTube is bullying me right now, so I need all the support I can get. Go down, hit that like button. Boys and girls, the only people left in Ottawa right now are me and Dustin. So you already know we're linking up. And when me and Dustin link up, we get some stuff done. Right now, you guys can see there's bubble wrap being pondered over here. I'm probably gonna pick up a bunch of that today because me and Dustin are, this isn't for a prank, but this one is for like, let's just say that something big is gonna be made today. Okay, I'm gonna pick up one of these and Dustin's gonna pick up one, I think. Maybe a pink one. New toy alert, boys and girls. Let's see what we got today. If I can open this. Wolfie, you wanna know what it is? Look at Wolfie's head. Hold on, buddy. Okay, this is not opening, we need a knife. Dustin, any guess what this is?
Some type of slime.
Nunchucks alert. Oh. Guys, we got the nunchucks. They're pretty cool, but these are like the training nunchucks. These are the only ones I could find. Oh, so they are soft. So we're gonna have to do some damage with these. Okay, I don't know how to use nunchucks. When your sandwich is just the way you want it, you ring the bell. Here. I haven't eaten at Subway in so long, but your boy has to eat it. Like, I haven't eaten today. It's like 4 o'clock. I gotta stop starving myself until times like this. But I'm about to devour this meatball sub. And like I always say, here. God damn, guys. She really did make the perfect sub. For a meatball sub, this is really challenging to do because there's so much meatball and like sauce in it. So when you make a good meatball sub without it falling apart, I applaud you, shout out to this girl, she killed it. The problem when we shop at stores is that we wipe out entire sections of one particular product. So right now, Dustin is finding an employee to go find more of this specific product because we're saving our money like Ryan Sways and not getting the most expensive brand, but they give us more bang for our buck and it's cheaper, so why not? The guy at the store said, Wolfie, can I have a bowl of your cereal? I was like, nah, bro, it's already good. You already have one. But you don't have anyone to do puns with, you pun yourself. What car do you drive? I don't know, a Kia. Dustin, I think you have too many Rice Krispies. Could you put those back? They're wavy, I'm wavy. So I found these new things, banana bread flavor shreddies, which sound wavy. So I'm trying these banana flavored shreddy trick shots. I just hit two in a row. Let's see if I can go for three. Nah. That's more like it. Here we go. Please, for the love of God, if you have a car and you care about your car and you drive your car, do not put eyelashes on your car because it looks so ugly. Just Jesus. Anyways, we got hooked up. The guy thought they were all not name brand, but half of them are name brand. So we got the discount either way. When the cashier messes up, guys, you want to put the stuff in the trunk or in the cart as fast as possible so he doesn't notice. So that's what I did. I swear to God, guys, the weather here is so moody. The boys are sitting in Cancun. My girlfriend's in New York. I'm going to say this a billion times. And the weather is pretty nice there. The time that we went in to grab like six rolls of tape came out. There was no rain, by the way, when we came in. Now,
there's something that
it's like flooded. This is like gross, 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 gross. I'm going to one of these sheds. Get cover. Here, we got cover.
Why are we in here?
We got a nice window. I don't know why we're in here.
I kind of like
taking cover. So you do when there's so much rain. Wait in the shed until it goes away and then go to the car. All right, guys, so DIY Wolfie is back again. You guys already know, last time I made gum, I made regular Skittles gum and sour Skittles gum. I think I made my parents try it and I made Sylvia try it. And they both thought it was really good. Turns out, I kept a bunch of the supplies, except some of the supplies are gone. It looks really messy, but there's enough to make one more, or at least two more batches. So today, since you guys really like the first one, we are gonna be making Warheads bubblegum. Very simple to make. I think there's like four ingredients.
You think that exists already?
I don't think it exists.
No?
Wait, does Warheads have gum?
I don't know.
They might have gum, but they don't have DIY Wolfie Warheads gum made in DIY kitchen.
Fair enough.
So have a Skittle, tell me how it is. And
tastes like a Skittle.
All right. You know what Skittles taste like. It's not gonna be as good as my gum. Very simple, guys. All you will need You can go to the store and buy this bubblegum like packing kit. Or you can just go buy bubblegum base from the store. This is like the most essential thing. It makes it chewy like bubblegum. Whatever flavor you want. So I'm doing Warheads. You could do Skittles like we did last time. You need some citric acid, which comes in this package. Or you can go to the store and buy it. And then you need a flavoring and corn syrup. Corn syrup. But we don't have corn syrup today. Dustin said that liquid honey, just regular honey, can replace it because there's so little of it. It might be a little sweeter. So we might have to add in extra Warheads. But without further ado, let's start making it. I just thought of the most genius idea. Instead of taking these out individually and crushing them, why not crush them in the bag that they're already in to avoid a mess?
I like that.
Get all the Skittles crushed.
I like that.
I like that.
Wait, wait.
What?
Can you just give me like a few?
Put your hand in there. Go ahead. So you just want to crush them all up into small pieces, and they're starting to come out of the bag. They're not even crushed. What the heck?
Oh, that's a crush sound.
You hear that?
Okay, what?
Why are these the strongest candies ever? Oh, that's a crush sound. That's a crush sound. I'm breaking the cutting board. Why is the cutting board breaking? Ah! Okay, so now that we got the Skittles, not Skittles, the Warheads crushed up, we open it, it should be in a nice Warhead dust like that. We're getting a mix of every flavor right here. Check it out. Warhead dust alert. Oh my God, that's sour. So you just wanna do that to all of them and I'll be right back. All right, so the Warheads are nice and blended up. I don't know why I pounded them when I realized we have a friggin' blender. So I blended them up, very small crystals now. So we're making Warhead gum and then I think we're gonna do like a mix of watermelon and mint. I don't think that's really a flavor, but those are the two flavors we have. We're gonna grab the mint flavor, very minty. Put that all there as well as the watermelon. Oh my God, that's gonna be weird. Now we're done with those. The next step in each of these bowls is going to be 2 tablespoons of powdered sugar.
Or not 2 tablespoons of powdered sugar.
One, I swear it is 2. No, oh my God. I might be doing this wrong, guys. How did I do it last time? I don't think I put the powdered sugar first. One sec.
Saying corn syrup's not your biggest problem.
No. Okay, we're going back on that step. The first step is getting the actual gum base in each of these bowls, because we're gonna melt this up and then swirl it around after. So basically, grab the gum base.
Bro, what is gum base?
It's the base of gum.
Yeah, but like,
it's like,
is that a single ingredient?
And maybe you need this, otherwise you can't chew it.
I know, but is that like a seed that grows on trees? Like, what is gum?
I think this is car tires.
Have you ever eaten
rubber?
You ever ate that by itself?
No.
Did you just try it? Maybe it's not nasty. It's just like chewing an eraser. That's what I imagine.
It's just gum with no flavor, but it's chewy. So we're gonna add, I think, wait. 1 tablespoon of gum base to each one. So here's 1.
That's accurate.
And here's 2. But we wanna double up on the recipe and use all of it. So here's 2, and here's another 2. But we wanna triple up on the recipe. So here's 3, and then here's kind of 3. Now we use it all, here. Next step, throw them in the microwave. So the next step is adding the corn syrup. We don't have it, so we're adding the liquid honey. It says 1 tablespoon, but we're doing like triple the amount. So we're basically doing 1 of those, little heaping one. We don't really measure too accurate. And then that's 3. And then in this one, there was a little bit less. So 1, 2, and then a little dab of the 3rd. We're gonna mix that around. As you guys can see, it was in the microwave. It's turning into some nice, I swear it's only gonna taste like honey.
Yes.
But now we're gonna add the flavoring in this one. This one's gonna be like sour watermelon mint and keep stirring around like this. Ooh, now it's smelling good. And then for this one, we're gonna add in our flavoring, which is ground up Warheads. How many? Like 1, 2, and 3. We want a lot of Warheads in there. And just to make it a little more sour, we're gonna add some of the citric acid as well. Oh, that's gonna be sour. So there's that. A little bit of, AKA 1 tablespoon of the powdered sugar, but we're not gonna measure, so like so. And now we're just gonna keep mixing them. I will be back in a sec. So I added some red food coloring to the Warhead one, and I added green food coloring to the other one, and that's just microwaving because it was hard to mix. The warmer it is, the easier it is to mix. So we are almost done. There's one more step called kneading. Basically, it's just like playing with it in your hands like bread dough. Look how easily that mixes, guys. Yay. Green watermelon mint sour. Woo! Sour Warhead. God damn. This is legit probably some of the most sour bubblegum in the world. Citric acid is literally like a step below malic acid, and malic acid is most sour thing you can buy, period. If we had malic acid here, I would use it, but citric acid is gonna have to do for today. And just to make it a little more sour, more citric acid alert. Guys, with the kneading, basically what you wanna do with this icing sugar is make a nice circle in the center of it, and we're just gonna pour the hot gum, I warmed it up 1 more time, in the very middle of it, like so.
God damn. DIY God right here. We're gonna do the same with the other one. Put this in here so it's not leaking everywhere. Okay, so grab the spoon.
I feel like you should have put wax paper down or something.
Ah! I should have, I really should have. This is probably
good. It's not like that cutting board has a giant crack in it that the
what crack?
Gum is gonna seep into.
I don't see any crack.
That gum looks beat.
Whoa,
that
whoa,
looks
whoa.
Delicious.
Chill.
Looks beat.
Chill! Now we need more icing. We need more icing sugar.
It's not like this is solidifying slowly.
It is solidifying, but you wanna knead it. Peep this. More icing sugar means we can actually touch it because this stuff is friggin' boiling hot right now and you don't wanna touch it with your hands. So basically, not all the icing sugar we're gonna eat because that's a lot of sugar, but you want to, with your hands, kind of fold it over itself. And as you can see, the gum should start to merge with the icing sugar and solidify. So right here, it kind of looks like lava. Very cool though. So as soon as you put a lot of powdered sugar all over the gum, it's gonna look edible. Right now, it's just a bunch of goo. That's where they fool you. If you have icing sugar on it, it looks really cool, but it looks like goo otherwise. So just keep kneading it like so, folding it into the middle over itself, get more icing sugar, same thing. And we're gonna do the same with this one at the same time, like boom, 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 fold, fold, fold. Oh, this one's working, this one's working. See, this one is working for some reason. The other one is like, you didn't use our sugar and ingredients, so we're not gonna work for you. But this one is wavy, look at that. This is satisfying, look at this.
Slime. When that goes down, it's gonna be amazing.
Slime alert. So just keep doing this for like 5 minutes and the gum should be ready. Okay, so your favorite time and my favorite time, the taste test time. Dad, I'm gonna let you have a piece of this. I've rolled it into like nice little blobs. Choose. You can have one of the green ones.
Huge.
Just chew it. Just chew it. See if you can blow a bubble.
Can you cut it in half?
No.
It's a lot, man.
Just eat it. It's not fully solid yet. Okay, you can cut it. Go ahead. It's just gonna be sticky. So I want you to guess the flavor of that gum and tell me if it's good. Is it good?
Oh god.
This is like Iron Chef with it, like, we're waiting to get the reaction. It's is it good?
How well did you use the secret ingredient?
It's good? Mm-hmm. So can you blow a bubble?
There's mint in there.
Okay. What else? It's something that you people would like. What is it?
What do you, by you people, do you mean like
black
old
people? No, black. What do you mean? Black colored shirt people.
This sounds like controversial.
No, black shirt people.
Oh, okay.
What do you mean? Black pants people. What do you mean? Black, like, not your skin color. Oh. Just how does it taste? What is it? Yes.
Like watermelon?
Yeah, that's the one. Mm. So if you like it, blow bubble. Okay. It's blow bubbleable. So now I want you to taste this one.
That's a blow bubbleable.
It's blow bubbleable.
I'm gonna look that up on Urban Dictionary.
Now it is.
Relastable.
Relastable. So this one's Warhead, but before.
That looks like you pulled it off the bottom of like a table.
Yeah, not when you dip it in Warhead to make it even more sour than it already was.
I like that.
Powdered Warhead. My dad loves candy and loves sour, so this should be a treat. Here you go. This is almost the sourest gum of like in the world. Okay, you're done. Okay, you're done with that one, spit it out. And now taste the sourest gum known to man. And let me know what you think.
All right, I like it.
You like it? DIY God right here.
Bro, I told you the honey wouldn't make a difference.
Cause there's so much Warheads in that. It's like, is it sour? Or just like enjoyable sour?
Enjoyable sour.
I feel like the honey canceled some of it out.
It could even be more sour.
Okay, you're mod. I'm gonna taste the watermelon mint sour flavor. You can taste mint. You can't really taste, okay, you can kind of taste watermelon. Why is it so sugary?
More mint than watermelon, though.
Why is it so sugary? This is too much gum. I was one of those kids that ate gum until my mouth was full.
I can recall a couple of those moments, like fully.
There's too much sugar, you can't blow bubbles, man. You need to chew the sugar out.
It's too granular.
Yeah, granular?
Granular.
That's a nerd.
Hashtag facts.
I'm with two nerds right now. I'm too granular.
Three syllable words I don't understand. Hashtag nerd.
Too much viscosity in this.
There you go, you're getting some ways.
No, it's not viscous.
Nah.
Here. Good, but I wanna try the sour one. I'm a sour freak too, I love candy. So that one's probably, I'll give it like 7 out of 10. It's good though. Everything I make is good.
The Warhead one is better.
This one.
Still too much sugar.
The Warhead one's good. And it's not granular. It's pretty sour.
How is it not granular if you dipped it in that?
I don't know. You chew off that in like 2 seconds. And this one, there's like sugar, bro. I don't know where it's from. The Warhead one's good.
Oh, it might be the powder you put.
Mm-hmm.
Like the flavor powder.
This one keeps it sour. It's still sour. There's still sour. Endless DIY sour bubblegum. Sour is gum in the world.
It's that Willy Wonka gobstopper. Everlasting gobstopper.
Ah! I bit my cheek. Okay. On that note, Dustin's up. Ah! I got bleeding.
You like gum?
Yeah, kind of. I'm not like a Hubba Bubba guy.
Though. I'm a Hubba Bubba guy for sure. You see how I mean?
You can taste a watermelon.
Yeah, but it's granular.
It's gritty.
Mm-hmm.
Gritty is a good part.
Well, my gum is still sour.
It is still sour?
Oh my god. That might be the citric acid.
I'd buy this.
That's a nice gum.
Yeah, bro, this is definitely way more minty than it is watermelon-y, but you can taste it.
Okay, do you like sour?
No.
Then you're off. Because this gum is as sour as it gets, bro. And it's still, in my mouth right now, it's still sour. It's been like 2 minutes. Usually most gums have already run out of flavor. You can tell it doesn't eat sour candy. You are not a sour guy, eh?
I don't really like it. You get right here.
No, I don't get that. I don't know what that is. I'm enjoying it.
I like it.
It's good. It gets better.
It's like Sour Patch Kid gum. And that stuff's new.
It gets better.
My dad's blowing massive bubbles. It's blow bubble bow.
After you chew it for about 10 minutes.
Yeah, this isn't granular at all. It's smooth.
It's really smooth.
Yeah. Bro, I'm salivating so hard though because it's sour.
It's so sour. Oh my god. Peep this.
This is exactly like, I just had a pocket.
It's still so sour. I'm cheesed. So DIY bubblegum, blow it like this. On that note, we're done that.
Somebody hired me for the NBA. Dustin was just challenging me to spin the ball on my finger. And I said, here, Ryan, hold that. Hold.
No, it wasn't really a challenge. That. Some people just overreact and make competitions out of anything.
This finger. Yeah, I'm super competitive. Guys, watch this. Or this. Middle finger, this finger, ooh. this finger, all the way back.
Insert Globetrotter music.
What is that Globetrotter? What is, how does it go? It's like whistling.
No, it's your, that's your theme song.
That's my song.
Bro,
that's
what, like, is it?
That's like,
it's similar to your
whistling.
Song.
I know there's whistling. But peep this, on a pen, can you guys do this? Yes or no? Here, it's like my fidget spinner. Oh! Are you playing it?
Yes.
If you
I'm trying to find it.
Put the song on, I'll be able to do it. Oh, Dustin!
I got you.
Here, pen! On a pen!
Wow.
Let's go!
Not bad.
Now play this song. You know these? Here, palm a ball trick to finger spin, shoulder.
Yeah.
A new spider? Do this.
Oh yeah, spider. This is actually low key hard. I can't. I can do it for like a couple seconds, but.
No, it's so bouncy. Ah! Oh. The people that can do it fast.
Can you do the the spin around your chest and then you go down the back?
I can't do the spin on my chest at all.
Really?
No.
Oh, bro. Toss me this. Toss me this.
Can you do this, though? Okay.
The one talent this white man has.
Here?
No, Dustin can do this wavy.
I keep it going.
I can't do that.
Oh, wait.
How'd you learn that?
I just practiced a lot. So
but can you do... I don't know what else there is.
So you go around like this, again and again and again.
I can't even do it once. How can I do it all the time?
But then you do this one. So you go around the first time, you throw it up, and then you go...
Chill. Can you do that?
Yeah.
You gotta say, make me like Mike.
Make me like Mike.
Power of Jacob Sartorius. Oh!
I thought I got it.
Toss it? I'll do it. Wait, first try.
And then you flick it back up. What I can do is this. Spin into this.
Oh! Hey, there you go. You like pull it and then just flick it back up.
Bro, what is going on? I look so freaking retarded right now. Here! To this. Oh!
Not bad.
To this. We're done here.
This is so weird, guys, right now. I just got home and it's just me and the two dogs right now. I brought the two dogs because I needed cuddle buddies for the night. Literally, I'm solo dolo right now in this house. I can yell. Sylvia's not gonna be like, shh, quiet down. I can be as loud as I want. I can watch whatever I want. Not like Sylvia stops me from doing that anyways, but I can yell. Jeez, Sylvia, come back. I miss you, literally. It's only been like, not even a full day. Hey, Wolfie, now I gotta clean up, feed the dogs alone. Everything. I applaud people that look after their dogs solo dolo because it is hard.
What are you doing? I swear these dogs do not believe that Sylvia's gone. So they're like waiting by the door and smelling around to like look for Sylvia to see if she's here. That's the first thing they did when I brought them in the house. They're like, where's Sylvia? Sniffing around the house, looking through each room. And she's not here, boys. It's just me. It's your dad today. Good boy.
So I'm gonna end off the vlog right now with the two little munchkins, as this one is called Nugget, and then this one's Polar Bear, as Sylvia would say. So everyone, I not only want you to go down and smash that like button and hit 35,000 likes on this vlog for no reason, but I want you to comment down below Nugget, if you're Team Nugget, which is Team Prince, because that's his nickname, and then Team Polar Bear, if you are Team Wolfie Jr. Hashtag Team Nugget or Team Wolfie Jr. We'll see who has more people. They'll be reading the comments, so probably if you guys wanna put both, that would be the best option, because they get hurt if they're not like winning like me. They're competitive dogs, I taught them well. But other than that, again, I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog, and I will see you guys soon on more Wolfie, where we stay a little bit, guess it, because he's a little dog, bit more savage than my main channel, and as always, stay savage, Lego. Do the outro, Prince.